hope you had a happy holiday, happy new year. Welcome back to Music Maker Guitar Videos. And today, in unboxing, this was my Christmas present from my wife, so I'm very happy about this. It's cool. So, here it is. Only thing I did was rip off my address so you can see where I live. But anyways, that said, let's do this thing. I'm actually going to use a little baby knife today. Good tape job. I got this from Amazon. So, good job, Amazon. So far. More tape. So, start out that it looks like they gave me all the tools and little guitar cable. I'd be surprised if that's a good guitar cable. It looks really pretty cheaply made. No meaning to insult anybody at Amazon. But yeah, maybe I could use it for something. And then we got my action tool, truss rod tool, little Allen keys. We have the guitar. A slide, I think. I can't tell what it's called. Alright. Anything in here? No. I like that it comes with a gig bag. Oh yeah. You can see what I see. Alright, let's take it out. It's pretty lightweight. Go. Eight strings. This was the cheapest eight string guitar on Amazon. It's actually pretty cool. It's got some plastic still on there. Looks like we got a couple of humbuckers. Three-way switch. volume tone, I assume. And there we go. Let's see if we can tune it up. Feels really floppy on the bottom. I might have tuned it wrong. Anyways, the story behind wanting to check this out is Pete over at Loudo Guitars. I was over there maybe 2 months ago now, and he said, yeah, play this guitar. It was, there's a band called Out of the Beard Spaces, and their guitar player's name is Zach Lopresti. He's an amazing player. And he had his 7-string, and he said, play Zach's 7-string. Tell me what you think. And I'm like, no. There's no way. I've only played 6-string guitars my whole life. This is what I do. I've picked up a ukulele and had some fun, but really it's like... 6-string guitars is kind of my thing, and I'll play some bass too, but really 6-string guitars is that's what I've done my whole life. And anyways, he put the 7-string in my hand. I'm like, there's no way I'm gonna be able to handle this. And anyways, I had a lot of fun with it. I was like, whoa, I just get lower notes now. And me being a funk guy, I like low notes, and so to add a couple more strings on here, kind of get them. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to kind of jam on this a little bit. Neck feels kind of wide, not going to lie. I'm not super used to that, so it's going to take some playing. But anyways, so the story is he put the 7-string in my hands. And I was like, I think I can handle this, and I really like the low notes. And he's like, well, should we do a 7-string? And I thought about it, and I said, you know what? 7 works. Why not try for 8? I love low notes. So get a lower string on here, and that's the story behind this. I'm not going to do probably what most 8-string guitar players do. A lot of the people that I see playing these kinds of guitars, they do more like a metal thing, or hard rock or something, or djent. But I'm not really planning on doing all that. I'm a big like Charlie Hunter fan. He plays a lot of like 8-string stuff with bass lines. I don't know that I can really hack all of those bass line things or all of that, especially to begin with, but I can certainly like loop some bassy sounding stuff and just have a fuller range of instrumentation here going on. So I think that's pretty sweet. Anyways, hope you enjoyed this unboxing. I'm gonna go ahead and plug it in and play it, and we'll show you that stuff for Tone Tuesday tomorrow. All right, have a good one.